Today we want to look how we can connect a tube with two endings, with two helmets, with tangent constraints. We have this here, and the first what we can look at is a solution. And we can look what means tangent constraints. I hide the solutions. We can see here the tangents from the tube and the tangents from the endings, and we want to have an surface which fits the tangent conditions. So here we have the complete tangent picture, and now we make the light on and we have the solution this way. And what is the fine structure? First the picture, the dependency graph. We have two helmets here and here. We have a tube, and then we construct two connectors, this one and this one, and the B grid are some helper to display the grid around the objects. Okay, how we can start? The first thing what we need is a tube. We have it here, and we change the size a little bit. Oh, that's lot. Okay, the next what we need is a helmet. So, and to connect them, we move the tube down. And we here we have the helmet. And we can change it a little bit. We can start editor. And make it a little bit larger. Okay. And we change the height of the helmet. So we have here the height, we say 400. Should be enough. We have this kind, and we also can change the other objects. Oh, I will close this. Okay, and we change here the layout too. So, okay, now we select the helmet and the tube, and we create a connector between these two elements this way. And now we can see we have here some twisting, and we can reduce the twisting. We have here an offset. So this way we have a good mapping. I hide here some helper curves. Oh, I have to hide this and this one. So this is the first connection from this side. The B connector also has here a tangent factor, so I can force the tangent on this way. At the moment it's 1. I can set it to 5. So in this case the tangent becomes stronger. and to get a useful result. The only thing what I can do now is I can move my tube down. So, and we can also reduce the tangent factor back to 1. Okay, this is one side, and now we can do the same on the other side. We can say we create a second helmet. And we move the helmet down to this place. We edit the helmet. So, okay, display the tube, and now we have to change the height again of this helmet, say 800 or 1800, make it a little bit larger, and we rotate it. Okay, and once more we connect the helmet with the tube. Create a connector. So the default connection is that I connect with the first edge, and now I have to switch to the other side. So I switch down, and now it seems okay. But I also have here a conflict. This is twisted. And the only thing what I can do, I can reverse the order of one of the rings, of this one or the other one. This is this flag. So now we have the solution. Maybe that the helmet is too small in the size, so we can re-edit the helmet. So I have to hide it for a moment. And we change the size, make it big. Okay. And close it. And we look at the connector. It looks like this. This is the tube. And we see we have here some strong edges. That means we have to change once more the offset. Okay, to get a good solution, and also we can now change here the tangent factor once more. We can say from 1 to 3. So it becomes stronger, and the same is possible on the other side too. So this way we have it, and I redisplay the other side too. We hide other structures. So now we have the connection, and we also can change the tube. We can replace it by another cyclic NURBS, but also we can add some noise. This is for testing enough. Let's say here is some noise, and we see if I deform the tube, the connectors will follow on it. So at the end we have a look at the solution with some of the helper tools of the Curzon workbench. We see here our solution with the Zebra tool, and I also can display the information about the connectors. So we can see here the form, here the tangent solution from both sides, and the same for the other side. Okay, that's for today.